What happened here is horrifying. Why it might have happened will leave you incredulous.
She was just a good girl.
Tina Meyer of suburban St. Louis is the mother of Megan Meyer, who had lived a challenging childhood.
She got bullied in school, and she had big self-esteem issues. She had struggled with depression since she was in the third grade.
Megan's mother and father allowed her to set up a MySpace account under their supervision, and said their 13-year-old swooned when she got her first affectionate note ever from a boy named Josh Evan.
He thought she was really pretty. Posted on her comments on her pictures, you know, this is beautiful, your eyes are beautiful.
For about a month, Josh sent her instant messages saying things like, lucky me and lucky you, because you're my number one. But Megan's mother and father started getting suspicious, because although the notes were not explicit, their parental instinct told them something wasn't right.
I did contact the police department, and I called and went, asked to be transferred to the cyber crimes division to see how can I check to see if this MySpace account is real. Nothing you can do.
And then one day,
it was a whirlwind. It was Josh saying horrible things to Megan, Megan saying things back to him.
Nasty messages from a boy who just a day before meant everything to this lonely girl. One in particular cut deep.
The world would be a better off place without you and have a shitty rest of your life.
Megan was distraught beyond words.
This is the part I'll never forgive myself for, because she was looking for me to help calm her down like I normally always did and be there for her. And I was upset with her because I didn't like the language that she was using. And I was upset that she didn't listen to me and sign off when I told her to. And so I was aggravated with her about that and told her that she knew better. And she just said to me, you're supposed to be my mom. You're supposed to be on my side. And she took off running upstairs.
It was too quiet for too long in that upstairs bedroom.
Tina left, walked upstairs. I didn't really pay much attention to it. And then I just heard a blood-curdling scream.
I just saw her hanging from her closet.
When she just screamed, I was right there.
I tried picking her up.
I held her, and I yanked the whole closet thing out of the wall, and Tina ran and got a knife so I could cut the belt from around her neck and then started performing CPR.
She had tears the entire time running down the side of her face the entire, until she passed away.
Just like, please, please, Megan, breathe.
Megan was pronounced dead the next day.
Tina Meyer will never forget the anguish her impressionable daughter felt when a boy calling himself Josh Evans on the popular social networking site MySpace suddenly turned mean and insulting. Tina ordered Megan off the computer and her daughter stormed off to her room.
I went upstairs and opened the door and saw her hanging in the closet and screamed and ran over and tried picking her up.
6 weeks later, they learned there was no Josh Evans, that it was all a cruel hoax created in the home of neighbors Lori and Kurt Drew, whose 13-year-old daughter was unhappy with Megan. While authorities investigated, Lori Drew denied involvement, pointing the finger at this woman, 19-year-old Ashley Grills, as the mastermind of the fake account. But Grills, a longtime family friend of the Drews, insists that Lori was deeply involved in the deception.
Who said, let's go online?
That was me and her daughter, and then she said, that sounds like a good idea.
Lori Drew said that?
Yes.
So she was in from the beginning?
Yes.
No doubt in your mind?
No doubt.
And then you created the character?
Yes.
Ashley says she found a photo of a good-looking teenager and named him Josh Evans. Josh then contacted Megan. It was a prank, she says, to find out if Megan was gossiping about the Drew's daughter.
What did you know about that friendship and whether there was any trouble between them?
There was always trouble. They'd be friends 1 week and in an argument the next.
The fake friendship went on for weeks, with Josh flirting with Megan.
And did everybody take turns writing at some point?
Basically, yes.
Lori, ever?
A couple of times.
So Lori actually sent messages as well?
When we didn't know what to say.
You're sure?
I'm positive.
Now, Lori Drew has said through her lawyer that she did not create or direct anyone to create the Josh Evans MySpace account, that it was really all your idea.
True? Yeah, that's not true at all.
Why would she say that?
To cover her own self, I guess.
So you go on and you're typing and you're going back and forth and it's fairly innocent. Then it starts to get nasty.
Mm-hmm.
Nasty messages.
Yes.
Then there's finally a really nasty message. Do you remember it?
Yes.
What did it say?
Our world would be a better place without you.
Who wrote that?
I did. I was trying to get her angry so she would leave him alone and I could get rid of the whole MySpace.
So you wanted to end it?
Yeah.
By now, Ashley says she was feeling guilty about the trick.
So this message is sent out and then something terrible happens in the Meyer household.
Yes.
What is going on there?
My daughter just hung herself.
It was October 16th, 2006, when the Myers world was shattered.
What did you think? What did you feel?
I thought it was my fault.
So what goes through your mind when you hear that a teenage girl that you all just played a joke on has committed suicide?
A lot of things, like it was my fault. I shouldn't have said what I said.
She says that Kurt Drew insisted that she quickly close down the MySpace account and that Lori instructed her to keep quiet. For a year, Megan's parents remained silent while Missouri officials investigated, but they soon went public with their story. A firestorm erupted with Ashley Grills right in the middle. Weeks ago, she testified before a grand jury in California, where MySpace is based. Criminal charges are being considered there.
What kinds of things did you hear from people?
They would tell me to kill myself and save everybody the trouble.
People say they don't understand it. How could this have happened? Who could be so cruel? Who's to blame?
I guess all of us. I mean, I'm partially to blame. They're partially to blame.
What do you want people to know about you?
That I'm not heartless. I do know what I did, and I take responsibility for it every day.
A month passed as the Myers struggled with their grief, searching for answers why their daughter went to such extremes, and who was the boy who drove her there. Then a neighbor told them something stunning. Josh Evans was actually the creation of a mother who lived on the same block as the Myers, a mother who actually went to Megan's funeral. According to an official police report, that mother acknowledged it. The report saying, in the months leading up to Myers' daughter's suicide, she instigated and monitored a MySpace account, which was created for the sole purpose of communicating with Myers' daughter. The Myers were told the other family wanted to find out from Megan why she was having a dispute with their own 13-year-old daughter.
As if my daughter would have killed herself with a gun. They loaded the gun for her.
We are not reporting the name of that other family to protect the identity of their daughter, but did go to their home to try and get their side of the story.
Is anybody home?
The woman's father answered the door. In a soft voice, the grandfather said it was sad, but then would not say if he thought the police report was wrong.
Have you talked to these people since then?
Yes, I have.
And what have you said to them?
Probably things that I can't say on camera.
And what have they said back to you?
Give it a rest.
Give it a rest.
Now at this point, if you're waiting to hear what law enforcement is doing in an effort to get Megan and her family some justice, well, you may be waiting forever. County prosecutors, the county sheriff's office, and the FBI say there is no indication whatsoever a crime has been committed, so there are no plans to do anything legally. After initially telling us they weren't even investigating the case anymore, the prosecutor is now telling CNN his office will review the situation. But more than a year has gone by since Megan hanged herself. Tina and Ron Meyer, who have separated partly because of the stress, were told by lawyers it was best to stay quiet, but they no longer are. They are angry and feel they owe it to Megan to speak out.
Maybe your story could help the welfare of another child.
Absolutely.
That's what we hope.